Dear students, let us discuss the rebellion of Kitturu and achievement of Rani Chennamma. The Kittur Rani Chennamma was a Rani or Queen of the Nayaks of Kingdom of Kitturu, ruled Mallarudra Sarja, who were vassals of the Maharaja of Mysore. The Kittur Rani Chennamma was a famously remembered freedom fighter who led an armed force against the British East India Company in 1824 in defiance of the doctrine of Plebs to retain control over her territory, but was defeated in the war and died in a prison. Kittur Rani Chennamma was one of the first female freedom fighter to resist British colonization, even though she is a national heroine well known in Karnataka and a symbol of the independence movement in India. Let us discuss how she reacted with the British because of doctrine of Plebs. Kitturu lies between the Dharwada and Belgaum. Here problem arose after the death of her Mallarudra Sarja. So Chennamma, the queen of Mallasarja, took active interest in the administrative matter after the death of Mallarudra Sarja. So when Mallarudra Sarja was died, his first wife's son Sivalingarudra Sarja took over reign of the Kittur, but he was unwell. Due to that, Chennamma had to take care of day-to-day administration. When Sivalingarudra Sarja was the king of Kittur, he had supported the British during Maratha War. As a result, the British entered an agreement with Kitturu and collected payment from him. When Thomas Munro was a British officer during that time, agreement was entered. After the death of Sivalingarudra Sarja, Chennamma adopted a boy named Sivalingappa and started ruling Kitturu as a queen regent. After the death of Mallarudra Sarja, his first wife's son came to power. His name is called as Sivalingarudra Sarja. He also died. After the death of Sivalingarudra Sarja, Rani Chennamma had adopted a boy named Sivalingappa and she started ruling Kitturu as a queen regent. Then Thackeray was the collector and political agent of the British in Dharwada, who had sent a report to the British governor of Bombay and attempted to take over Kittur kingdom under the doctrine of Plebs. This Thackeray had sent report when Kittur and Chennamma adopted a son and started ruling over Kittur. He reported to the British government, she is going against of the doctrine of Plebs, and he started to attack over the Kittur. But his attempts to take over Kitturu and its treasury was failed because Kittur and Chennamma considered war as inevitable, so she prepared for the war. The same time, British also prepared themselves for the war. In the beginning, Thackeray was shot dead and many of the British were taken as a prisoners of the war. Later on, a British brought strong or huge army under the leadership of Colonel Duncan. The army fought the battle bravely and Chennamma was trying to escape from the battlefield, but she was captured by the British army. Not only she, even though Others who were supported to her were imprisoned at Bailongala fort, and finally she was passed away in the prison. The name of Sangoli Rayanna has remained famous along with the name of Rani Chennamma. This Sangoli Rayanna was born on August 15, 1796, was an Indian military, means Sainik and warrior in the Kittur Princely state of the Karnataka. He was the Sainik of the Kingdom of Kittur ruled at the time by Rani Chennamma and fought the British East India Company till his death. He fought for the independence of Kittur and felt it was his duty to liberate his motherland. He fought against the British and was imprisoned along with her. Later on, he was released by the British. When Kittur revolt was going on, during that time, Britishers were arrested Rani Chennamma as well as Sangoli Rayanna, but Sangoli Rayanna got released later on. After his release, he developed a sense of nationalism and went on organizing an army. He formed army. In his army near about 500 soldiers were there, and he was conducting secret meetings at sensitive places. He became furious with the villagers who were assisting the British army, and the British thought that Rayanna was being instigated by Rani Chennamma. That's why British shifted her to Kusagal prison from Bailongala fort. This Sangoli Rayanna became very famous, and it was the problem to the British, so that British devised a cunning strategy to capture Rayanna. They supported and encouraged Desais who were opposing Rani Chennamma rule in Kitturu. An Amaldar named Krishnaraya joined hand with them. Thus Rayanna was cunningly captured and brought down to the Dharwad. So this Krishnaraya, he supported to the British. He arrested Sangoli Rayanna and brought down to Dharwad. Many of his soldiers surrendered after his arrest, and he was declared as an offender and was hanged to death. Many of the peoples till today, they believing that Rayanna was a bravery and he fought against the British to liberate the motherland. So many Balads have kept the life and bravery of Rayanna alive even today.